famous photo of him coming at you in the orange car on some Goodwood or someplace. It was really
cool. Oh, we'll see.
Yeah, we're fans.
He died of Beth.
Okay.
Yeah, he went, his son on Christmas Day went for a swim in a lake and we were all there and he drowned, 21-year-old. And then he just went downhill from then on and he went to Bathurst 4 years later and pulled the car up on the side of the track and he was dead. Heart attack.
I remember when he burned his hands at Indy. Doctors will ask me, I'll have some pain, and they'll say, what is that on a scale of 1 to 10? And I go, well, this was an 11, you know? My wife and I, on the way back from New York one time, we stopped at a cemetery and Peter Revson's is there. And I wanted to see that. His brother also was a racer, also died. Yeah. But my wife sees his name and says, oh, I was on his yacht. Like a minor formula, it wasn't like Can-Am or anything. Yeah.
Well, as you said, we had a memorial for Denny and all of that. And you know, was at the airport on his way. Ayrton Senna was on his way to Formula One in Adelaide Grand Prix in that year.
Mm-hmm.
But he didn't come out when he was in the airport. And you know, 2 years later, something. And you never hear.
They don't want to tell it. And I go skiing like, no, he had a skiing accident. And I go skiing and boarding all the time, and I think, oh, I could, you know, sprain my wrist or break a leg. I just never think that could possibly happen.
Well, the day I left on August the 4th from Auckland,
mm-hmm.
And Sam died, so it was Denny Hulme, Bruce McLaren.
Yes.
Rio,
yes. Yes. Yeah, there's I think it's called The Flying Lap. There's an interview series on the web, and they did Chris Amon, like, I don't know, it was quite a while ago, but I just saw it, and then he passed away. He sponsored a car in Can-Am and Trans-Am. Some Essex Wire was his company. But he was racing a Nissan vintage IMSA car. And he had a horrible accident and he was burned. And I went to someone else's funeral and his widow was there. And I'd never met her. And we were talking about it. And she said, well, racing gave me, you know, 20 wonderful years. And then...
Thank you.
while you're like, you've got
yeah, we'll get something.
You know, I saw Denny Hulme at this vintage racing so and on Friday they were out, and you think that, well, that's as fast as they can possibly go. And he went on Saturday, and he went like 5 seconds fast. And he, I think he was taking it easy. I think he was taking it easy. Yeah.
Well, he had that nonchalant attitude.
Yeah. Well, nice to have met you.
Yeah, my dad, you probably don't know what it is, but the Victoria Cross, have you heard of that?
I've heard of it.
Yeah, in the Second World
War. Oh, yes, yes, yes.
My dad got that as well.
Oh.
So, if you go online and find out about the Huns.
Do you think that the Khan Death March was? He died of leukemia, and one theory is the bomb died of something, not radiation or something.
Oh, really?
But I never met him. I don't think he and I would have gotten along at all.
You just never know.
I think I know. Anyway.
Well, it's nice to meet you. I gave you my maiden name, so I'm Anita Hulme.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
All right. I live in the colonies, New England.
Where's that?
Northeast United States. I live in a little state called Vermont.
Oh, I've heard of
Vermont. Yeah, we went to high school together. And he lives in California. He still lives in California, so we do this like every 4 years.